Okay, just before we go for lunch, we have another very interesting Sky Talk, and it would be delivered by Monsieur Nicolas Wackley. He is in the cargo and mail screening equipment with CHIA as the global solution manager. So we're very much looking to your presentation. Et voilà, Monsieur Wackley.
So, good day, everybody. Thank you very much for attending the Sky Talk, our Sky Talk. So, I'm very pleased to be here today, back in Montreal, which used to be my hometown for a long time. And I'd like to thank ICAO for giving us the opportunity to present to you today our solutions. So, went a bit fast. So most of you probably know us from these items. So we've been around for 50 years now. We are an Italian company, and we are well known in the airport industry for providing passenger security checkpoints. So walk-through metal detectors, handheld metal detectors, and more lately, liquid explosive detection systems, but also shoe scanner for metal and explosive detections. So we've been speaking for 45 minutes on passenger HAVSEC. However, I'm not going to discuss that right now. So I'm going to do something a bit different for once, because we are also present into the air cargo screening environment. So air cargo screening is what is said to be by many experts the weak spot of aviation security. Part of this problem is that standard and best practices are not as well defined as they are for passenger security checkpoints. So for the next 15, 20 minutes, I'm going to try to give you some information of what current technologies are, what they do, their advantages and limitations. And I'm also going to introduce to you our cargo screening solutions that have been around for the past few years, very recent technologies. So when it comes to air cargo screening and air cargo security, so the threats are not exactly the same as passenger security. When it comes to air cargo, we do not look about firearms, knives, or even explosives on their own. The threats are improvised explosive devices. In other words, the threats are assembled bombs. So bombs are made of explosive matter, detonators, trigger circuits, and also batteries as a power supply to trigger the detonation. So we're going to see that most technologies available for cargo screening are trying to catch one of these components, and where we stay us at CHEA. So here is a list of what is currently being done in the air cargo screening environment. So we're going to go through each of these technologies very quickly to focus more on our solutions. So I'm going to start which is probably the most known. So we talk about dual view X-ray transmission, so non-computed transmission. I'm not talking about computed tomography CT scans. So these devices, which are the most spread across the air cargo screening environment, are generating images, and you have a human operator trying to find actual bumps within the commodities goods being screened. So advantages of these dual view X-ray transmission, as a first, very large aperture are available with 1.8 by 1.8 meters being approved by most civil aviation authorities everywhere. Then, because they are based on X-ray and generating images, they actually can allow a wide variety of commodities. And last but not least, they are reasonably affordable in terms of purchasing costs, as long as we do not go too high in the large apertures and high power generators. So limitations on these technologies, they have very limited detection capabilities, and especially with poor performance on IEDs. So this is due to the very dense items being going through and difficulty to penetrate actually the commodities when they are configured in skids. So they do have significant maintenance costs, and in most countries they require a license for the use of ionizing radiation. And last but not least, again, they do rely on human operator interpretation. Now, explosive detection systems, so for standard 3 and more, so these are actually X-ray based technology, taking care of analyzing the packages going through and detecting explosive matter automatically. So they have automatic detection, so no need for human operator, and you can screen a wide variety of commodities, which is definitely a good advantage. But they are price restrictive with a high maintenance cost, high purchasing cost, very limited in terms of shipment size. Currently doesn't go more than 1 meter by 1 meter, so forget about skids. And they also require license for use of ionizing radiation with a significant false alarm rate. So then, with that, we talk about explosive trace detection. So that focus also on explosive detection. They have fully automated detection. They are quite affordable compared to the previous ones. They do have a low false alarm rate, and they perform very well as a second level screening device. As a first level, that's definitely not the best technology to use for the following reason. First of all, you need to open the shipment, does generate a long processing time, not adapted for all type of commodities, forget about wet and humid goods with explosive trace detection, it's not gonna work. And it does depend on sampling performed by human operator. So again, we come back to what we've been discussing with the panelists and basically providing good training to the operators. So then explosive detection dogs, again focusing on the detection of explosive by scent. So advantage of having the cost evenly distributed, since you pay for a service, quick processing time and very reliable. However, they are not always available at the airport or in the cargo area. They are not approved for use everywhere in the world. They do require significant maintenance and training for both the dog and the handler, and they are not adapted to all commodities. So this being said, us, CHEYA, where do we fit in there? So over the past 2 decades, I would say, we've been working on what they call metal detection equipment. So think about a very large walkthrough metal detector for cargo screening. So basically it started pretty much 20 years ago when the first requirement for using MDE occurred in Europe and in France, to be accurate. In 2000, the first deployments of metal detection equipment occurred for screening cargo packages. And then in the middle of the 2000s, basically, North America with the TSA and Transport Canada on a combined project required CHEYA to work on something that could screen pallets and to think of a technology, a device that could perform the same thing on small packages but at the skid level. So in 2015, the European Civil Aviation Conference branch of ICAO introduced the MDE as fully part of the common evaluation process, and nowadays, in 2018, our solutions, the ME series, is currently approved and qualified for use in the US, in all of Europe, and in Oceania. So basically, the problematics we started with, the screening of dense cargo revealed itself quite difficult when using methods such as imaging or trace detection for the reason I've been discussing. When you see on the screen, so on the left, you can actually see a picture taken from fish skids. In the center, these are carrots, and on the right, actually bundles of magazines. So these are X-ray images, and you can see right away the problem. There is way too much dark in there. meaning that the X-ray, even though very powerful, did not penetrate the whole skid and eventually make it very difficult for a conscientious and serious operator to make a security decision. So we did have a requirement to use technology more suitable to these type of materials in order to detect threats more efficiently and more accurately. So, and this is how, basically coming back to the air cargo threats, when most of the other screening methods, they focus on the explosive matter itself, we focus on the metallic components which are necessary to trigger the bomb. So detonators, trigger circuits, and batteries. So after all, that's what we do. We are experts on the electromagnetic field, and we detect, we use this part of the physics to detect threats. So metal detection equipment, you detect detonators and the metallic components. So batteries, meaning also lithium batteries, any type, alkaline, whatever. So here are our series, the DMEs technology. So you see on the left our small unit for package screening, and on the right this bigger but the younger brother for screening skids. So operating principle is very, very simple. It does look like an X-ray, but actually it's a big metal detector. You just screen packages through without the need for an operator to actually check at any images, because there are none of them. There is an alarm in case of metallic presence, or the unit being cleared, the commodity is being cleared in case of passages go through properly. In terms of possible application, so obviously you understand that if it's a metal detection equipment, you cannot screen everything and anything with it. However, when you do have commodities such as perishable, so fish, meat, fruits, vegetables, whatever, live animals, print media, any kind of paper product, pharmaceuticals in bulk that are actually quite tricky when it comes to cargo security, liquids, plastic matters, wooden product. Basically, this is something that you can actually think metal detection equipment, and you can ask this kind of machine to be used and provide a very efficient security decision. So here you have actually two type of layouts that could be done. The small machines are quite fast with a very high throughput, up to 3,000 packages an hour. They can be fully integrated in line with a conveyor system, divesting system to orient towards other type of technologies. The larger ones, because we talk about intensive heavy forklifting, a lot of movements, they tend to be standalone, but could be integrated in line also if the warehouse, the screening facility had the proper conveyor systems. So operating principle, very, very, very easy. So just like a walkthrough detector at the airport, you go through. If no metal is detected, green light. If there is possible presence of metal detected, so possible threat detected, red light with an audio alarm. So here, this one is a video, I'm not sure. Yes. So here you have the large machine actually performing a transit using our biggest model, the MS-130-200. So this is actually pretty much 800 kilograms of fresh salmon being packaged into these skids. So it goes through the machine, and once it has performed the transit, which is around 25 seconds, basically, green light, nothing was detected in there. So, as you can see, there is actually no one in the area checking any screen because it's not required. The machine makes the decision on its own, and it's the machine which is being reliable and liable when it comes to the security of the commodity itself. So, on this one, it's the same pallet in which we actually hidden we've hidden a threat. So now you see it's going through, video jammed. Sorry about that. It's okay, no big deal. So what you should have seen was actually a red light. So on the next one, here we have something a bit different. So, yeah, no. So here it's in a fast parcel screening environment. So you see how fast the packages go through. So with this one is being cleared, the next one also. So with regard to what has been discussed before, actually, in this kind of project that we have with Express Courier, we are not trying to replace any technology in place. We're just trying to optimize their setup, combining different technologies. In this case, metal detection being something which is not very highly priced and affordable, it can be put as a first level. And we managed to clear more than 30% of the volume of an Express Courier being sent right away to the aircraft without having to be screened by explosive detection dogs, CT scans, or even trace detection. So in the end, these are the kind of things that are interesting for the industry when using this kind of technology. So what I would like you to remember about cargo metal detection equipment, so as a first, obviously, just like the name says, they do detect metal. They do not detect explosives or firearms, whatever. They detect metal. So advantages they have that they are obviously made to detect automatically, so you don't need any human operator to interpret any image or to make a security decision. The machine is reliable and liable for the result. They are quite affordable and they have a very low maintenance cost, which translate into a low cost of ownership over the life cycle of the equipment. Then they do have currently a very low false alarm rate, so you're not gonna have the metal detector triggering an alarm every time you screen a pallet. And obviously, given the process and the technology, the sciences they use, they do have very high throughput. So as I said, the small machine can push 3,000 packages per minute with a speed of 1 meter per second. The large one can do 2 pallets per minute. So limitations there resides into the technology itself. So it is only for specific metal-free commodities. Do not try to screen car spare parts with that. Obviously, it's not gonna work. So, and they do require also specific metal-free packaging. So in the end, and to join what has been told before, we've been discussing about more training, more innovation. In my opinion, we already have, in terms of technology, a very good baseline of devices and principles that have been tested and proven on the field. So in my opinion, what can be done to improve things, obviously quicker computing time to improve throughput, but also improving false alarm rate. So then, just like I've been discussing for Express Courier, we have the opportunity to have different technologies with different principles working in this, with different physics. So we should try to combine available devices much more, especially by increasing low-cost first filters and combine them, like metal detection equipment and dual-view X-ray equipment with an autoclear capacity, joining the gentleman who was discussing about artificial intelligence to clear or to unclear packages quicker. And then one of the most important, especially in the cargo field, just like operator might not be trained properly, when it comes to air cargo security, in my opinion, the stakeholders are not trained well to choose the best screening method with regard to their business core. So they are left to themselves the possibility to choose what they need to do. However, there should be probably more best practices determined by all of us. So I thank you very much for your attention, and if you need to ask me any question, our booth is just out there on the left, number one. Thank you very much, everybody.
Thank you very much, Mr. Wakli, for a very interesting, as you say, complimentary presentation to what was said this morning. Well done. Thank you so much. Yes, we're breaking for lunch, and we will have about an hour for lunch so we can gather our strength for this afternoon sessions. The lunch is sponsored by Osprey, and their booth is near the elevator on the right as you exit the hall and go to the end. We'll see you back at 13:50, and yes, we'll ring the school bell just to give you an indication of when to come back again.